Hey everybody, Lego Jang here with a final look at all of the villains from Lego's Hero Factory Breakout Wave 2, released in summer of 2012. If you want specifics on each of these, you will have to go back and look at my individual review videos that I've done for each of these. I've also done speed builds for all of them. It's actually a separate speed build video for Speed of Demon because it was so large and long. All the others have the speed builds built into the review videos themselves. I've also done the combination models of these and done videos of those when you combine these with the heroes that they officially are set to fight against. So this is just a final kind of wrap up and overview of the villains as a series. First thing, like with the heroes, we only have four this time, and that's four if you don't count Thornrax, who was released in the United States with Wave 2, but in the rest of the world is released with Wave 1. So it's up to you how you want to count that, but as far as the new ones that were just released is concerned, it's down to just four. And like I said, with the heroes, I really didn't feel that big of a loss of moving down to just having four. I think the four that they put in here are different enough and interesting enough that I still feel like we got a whole wave worth of new material with these guys. So I'm really not feeling that sad that there isn't a fifth one in here. Again, if you don't include Thornrax. So with the variety, we go from the very, very colorful Voltix, who is a more traditional style of character with two legs and two arms, but his big thing is his number of colors, his brightness, and the fact that he is so electric, and he's got large wires going around on him, and he's got all these electric jolts and bolts that are coming out like little sparks and bits of lightning, and the lightning whip added on. So a little bit of a traditional style, but then with extra flair added on top. You compare that to XT4, which is not traditional at all. I mean, it is walking on two legs, but they're not humanoid style legs. They're three jointed legs, and then, or three segment legs, and then he has four arms, and the arms don't really have hands on them. He's got one set of pincers over here, but it's all like tools. So he's a very utilitarian robot. So very, very different just style of character there. And some folks hate this guy, some folks love him. I love him. I think that he's just so different and has a lot of personality in his face that it worked out really well. Core Hunter, however, is, I usually try not to put too much focus on favorites because I don't want to influence folks into thinking that what I say is my favorite is the best, because that's just not true. Whatever is your favorite is the best for you. But my personal favorite this time is very definitely Core Hunter. I just like the color scheme that he has and the way that it came together. It's a very consistent look all throughout the character. I think it just looks more like one continuous thing all the way around from all angles. It's kind of hard to get black and red wrong as a color scheme, but just the total combination of everything that they did here with the armor, with the style of the head, with the wide chest plate, with the weapons, it just works out so well for me. So I'm really happy about that. Although he is somewhat of a more traditional style again, going back to just two arms and two legs, but the head is very different on this one. And then the star of this series is really Speed of Demon. He's the one who got the most emphasis. He's the one who gets to go up against the XL hero, Stormer XL. And he's also the largest set because he comes with this entire motorcycle. So I'm happy to see a vehicle come back into this series. I would like to see more of those. I think that every wave would do well to have a vehicle in it. Doesn't necessarily have to be something this complex, but even something smaller would be cool. But they got really brave, I think, with the design of this one, with purple and green as accent, as colors to contrast against each other. They're so different as colors, but I think it ends up working out somehow. And then even using the gold, the bright gold, the slightly orangish bright gold, you know, a lot of pearlescence to it. Again, brave, but I think they managed to pull it off. It's very different. It's not a normal color scheme that you see a lot of. It harkens back to the Constructicons from Transformers, all the way back to Gen 1, but they pulled it off. I do like the bike. I think the bike turned out pretty well. The way that he sits on the bike turned out pretty well. And as I mentioned in my individual review of him, I really like the fact that they just randomly added on a couple more arms for him, because you can get away with that because he is just a robot. You know, you can design any sort of weird thing with adding extra joints and put on two heads if you wanted. You know, remember Split Face had one half of one head and one half of another, part robotic, part organic, and it worked out because, you know, it's not trying to be a realistic human-based Earth story. It's out in space and in a different world. So good job to Lego overall of stretching the boundaries a little bit again, and trying some different things here. I think that this is a good solid set of heroes, of villains across the board. My least favorite of these personally is Voltix. Just the number of colors didn't work out so well for me. I would have preferred more of the purple or more blue or less gunmetal or something. Not more yellow, probably more of the blue to go in with his blue cords, electrical cords back here. But all of them still good. I'm still happy that I got all of them. They do introduce some new parts in new colors that we haven't had before, so I'm always happy about that because I'm a really big fan of custom mock making. And that just about does it for my thoughts on this series of villains. Again, if you haven't seen the individual review videos, those are all up. If you haven't seen the individual combination model videos, those are all up. And I will continue to review the new Hero Factory sets as they come out over time. But for now, it's time for me to get back to making custom mocks, my own creation. So I look forward to that very much. You can follow those as they come up on my channel here, youtube.com/LegoJang, and also on the blog at hero-factory.blogspot.com. Take care, and I'll talk to you again soon.